It is a service where we can group together all the policies and the management group that we've seen earlier. So it's a good way to drive policies. So let's take an example. So I'm going to create a Kubernetes blueprint for my developers. So they want to deploy Kubernetes for an internal project. So I'm going to deploy that on the spokes. And in my blueprint, you can see I can group different artifacts. So at the top level, I can put policy assignment, role, some template or resource group. Let me create a resource group. So this resource group will be where my resources will be deployed. So I'm going to name it KATS for Kubernetes. And that will be my resource group. You can also define the name of the resource group at deployment and the location as well, or you can force it at the definition. So let me go in my resource group. And in my resource group, I want to add additional artifacts. So the one will be a role assignment, but I can also use the ARM template to be able to deploy my Kubernetes cluster. So let me put the role. I want to give my developer a contributor role, but you can also give them a reader role. And then you can map it to an Azure Active Directory group. So this is my project. So if you add the user to this security group, automatically the user will have access to my blueprint. I click on add and I'm going to save a draft. So you can add much more in the blueprint, but for the purpose of this demo, let's save the draft as is. So now I've got a draft, and the next step is to publish my blueprint. I'm going to publish that blueprint and give it a version. So let's start with the 0.1, and I'm going to name it initial version. So now my blueprint has been published. The next step is to assign my blueprint. So think about the management group that we created earlier. So I want to assign this blueprint to the subscription linked to my Spoke resource group and Spoke management group, and this is for my subscription. So let's select it. Can define a location and pick up the versioning. I can also apply a lock. The lock is very good. So think about deploying, so scaffolding your subscription with some reference architecture. You want to make sure that the owners cannot change it. The lock will prevent that. So then put the resource group name. So that will be the name of my project, so project one. And I can also define the location. Where do you want this project to be executed? So it will be more in Southeast Asia. So I'm creating my resources in Southeast Asia, and I will get my Kubernetes cluster. So now the blueprint is going to scaffold my subscription. And if you click on Assign Blueprint, you can see that it is in waiting mode. So you click on it, and now it's going to deploy the resources. So you can see the resource group has been created. Now it's assigning the permissions and applying the lock, as you can see in the information. Now my blueprint has been deployed. Let's have a look and see my resource group. You can see this resource group has been created automatically by the blueprint. It's empty, but if I click on access control, let's see who has access. So click on role assignment. And you should be able to see in the contributor the Azure Active Directory group, which is the case. And on the deny, you can see that all the other principals have been denied access. So meaning that even if you give an ownership of that the subscription, they won't be able to touch the blueprint resources.